Hello everyone, my name is the Radman, and we are here for some Farming Simulator 2015, and I keep starting with one of my headphones off so I can hear myself, and I don't like hearing myself, because it sounds weird. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, so, I've discovered something about doing silage, and for those of you who usually don't get, like, modded trailers and stuff, you'll be fine. But if you like using modded trailers like I do, it might just irk you a little bit. Because what I've found out is the way that course play works, it doesn't actually, even if you have a trailer on a harvester that can collect stuff from the harvester, it doesn't actually count it towards what the harvester has in it. And if you, if course play is able to detect automatically that whatever vehicle you set it to is a harvester and it is a chopper, it's going to either, if you have course play on the chopper, then the chopper will not run until you get a truck by it, but the truck will also just follow the harvester. Because what I found out was, if I keep the trailer on the back, then it loads into the truck anyways, and the truck doesn't automatically go to the side of the trailer, it goes to the side of the chopper, and that's a problem. So I'm going to attempt to show you guys how we need to do this. The only problem is that since, the only problem is that since it doesn't let you have any extra, which I realize this now, but I actually don't pay my course play workers in more than fuel because I forgot to have that enabled and I don't know how to enable it without breaking the mod, so anyway, so what we need to do is we need to record a course, and then we have the truck on this mode, combi mode, which is empty combine and unload. So what we're going to have to do is make multiple courses that can run two or three trucks at a time. And I know that there are ways to make, like, trucks follow each other. I don't know how to do that, just because I only ever needed the one truck. So we're going to need to buy another truck. And we'll probably just have the exact same setup that we have here if I can afford it. Because what we'll need is we'll need enough trucks that while one of them is unloading in the bunkers, another one or even maybe two of them can be off waiting to be loaded into by the chopper. And that's how they do it in real life. I don't think I've ever seen a bunker trailer like that mod uses in real life ever. The major thing that I'm worried about is, especially when we finish a field, I'm worried about the trucks stacking up behind each other and then automatically seeing, like, the one, like, let's say there was two trucks here, like, let's say the trailer is another truck. So my worry is that this one's going to automatically come up here, be like, oh, okay, and then drive along, let's say it gets full here, and then it'll turn around and drive the unloading course, which is fine, and then it'll come back, and in the meantime, the trailer truck will have followed the chopper more, which is also good. But the problem is, I don't know if when we stop the chopper and move it to that field, if both trucks are going to automatically follow it, because I'm not sure if there's a special setting that you have to turn on, but we'll find out, because yeah. So I'll just show you guys how we're going to do this. So what I would do is we're going to try and record this so that multiple trucks can run. So we're going to start the course here, and where we have those bunker silos the way that they are, I'm not actually sure if it'll automatically fill them right, or if we'll just end up having to drive them there and then set a waypoint for them. Because the one problem that I've had, I don't know if this current game does it, but in the older game, if you overfill the silo and you were at a part that was already full, it would just delete the silage, which was a major problem I had. Just because you could have like one teeny tiny area on one silo that wasn't full, and yet you would delete an entire trailer worth without ever filling up that teeny tiny spot. Now it is kind of hard to do a trail that actually fits two trucks on the back roads, but that's partially why I have it, so that I can see all my waypoints, is so that I can see where they're going to go. Now, one thing we're going to have to keep in mind when we make the end of this trail is that the trucks are going to have to be able to, go where they need to without interfering with each other. So I'll just show you what I mean when I get there. So we're going to just pull in here. And for some reason, like, I've had trucks go sliding around those corners, because even though I put on my brakes, like, here, they don't put them on until it's almost too late. So what this'll do is now they'll trigger in here and then drive out, and I have to keep them driving fast. Ooh, I should also slow down time. I have to keep them driving fast, or else it'll cause problems. And originally when I discovered this about how the silage works, I was really worried it was going to mess everything up. But as I've been thinking about it, it basically just means that I don't need that back trailer anymore. But everything else that I had planned for, like setting up giant courses that'll automatically harvest hay, like I could probably, where I'm buying the extra trailers, I could probably have it automatically always be harvesting some, like, small amount of hay silage, just because hay regrows relatively fast at 120 times speed. But anyway, that's something that would be quite a ways off, as I'd have to do more experimenting. Also, I'll just show you, I've been thinking about buying an actual fertilizer spreader, especially for these small fields like that one over there, where my sprayer, like that big John Deere sprayer, gets stuck, because it's a royal pain in the butt to get that thing unstuck in some of the ways that it finds to get itself stuck sometimes. And obviously, once chopper is over in those fields over there, we'll have to change up the course and record a new one. But the nice thing is, if these courses do work, it should just take this course. So now we're going to stop this here, and you're normally not supposed to do something like this, but I think we should be fine for now. Let's just see. So as long as I don't select anything let's see, there we are, Crone Big X. So now it's going to go drive up alongside it, and we're just going to watch, because I've had a few issues with them hitting poles before, but it looks like we shouldn't have any issues, because I wish that, like, the big, like, cedars that, like, stick out to the point where they would hit the poles would automatically fold up and stuff, because it would just make it easier, but that's just a nitpick. Anyway, so that's going to pull up. We'll just generate a course for this. Southeast. Going west. Whoops. I hope that didn't mess up the course I had loaded. I'm not even sure what course that was. Okay. I have a bigger header than I had, because I'm using this one instead of that other puny one. So now if we just tell it to start, and we actually have it be in the right place, which now the truck's in the way. This is why you have it start at the first waypoint, and you don't get the truck going till the chopper is actually ready. And we'll drive now. Okay. You better... You know what? Just to be safe, first waypoint. What is wrong with you, you dumb thing? Stop it. Okay, drive. What the... Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to do what I call a switcheroo, where we just basically go all the way around. And yeah, this is one of the problems I found with course play, is especially if you have two machines that have to interact with each other to work properly, course play sometimes doesn't know what it's doing. Like right now. Oh my gosh, do you have like a header offset or something I didn't remember? No, you don't. You're just stupid. Okay, go around me, truck. Really not in the mood for this truck to be doing stupid things right now. And yeah, this is why you make temporary courses, is then you don't waste precious save space on junk like this. Drive a course. Okay, and what it should do is, yeah, it'll automatically stop if the truck goes out of range. You're an idiot because you're in the wrong mode, and I think it's because I got mad at it that it thought it needed to stop. So now what it should do, and I'm going to make it load 100% because I'm not crapping this. Whoops, 100%. And I can adjust that if we need to. In fact, I'm going to, because we're testing. So let's say at 10%, since it hasn't actually hit that trigger yet. And I'm not sure how the triggers work in this mode, so we'll just put them both at 10%. And that one at 0, because that might be like how much it needs to unload. I'm not sure. And now we'll see. So the truck gets into traffic while the chopper's turning. Oh, this is one thing I really didn't like about how course play does this. Is the trucks drive way out to one side. Which is why I'm worried about them hitting telephone poles and stuff, but maybe that's not going to be that big of an issue. Is there any settings I can change so it doesn't do that? Because I really don't like that. No. Yeah, that looks okay, whatever. So it should have triggered. I don't know what I did wrong. It might just be that this mode just automatically does what it wants and doesn't really care. But I'm going to, for the simplicity of it, just tell it to drive now, since the chopper's going to have to turn around anyway. So yeah, now it's going to find its way to the first waypoint, which it should be able to do, even with a few obstacles in the way. And now we'll see if it actually unloads like it needs to. And if this does work out, I'm considering live streaming this harvest so that I can get the bumps and stuff out of it. And obviously this episode will come out after the live stream if that happens. just because my internet is terrible. But the last time I tried streaming, it kind of just died and quit on me, so that wasn't fun. And more importantly, we're going to see if it can actually make it around these turns and stuff, because I've always had trouble with course play messing up the turns, like skidding through them. Or I think I had once where a trailer jackknifed, so the truck was looking at itself and it was giving the error message that it can't continue. And I find it interesting that the chopper isn't sending a message. So let's just, okay, yeah, the chopper stopped. That's the important thing. And I guess while we're waiting, we'll buy a new truck if we can afford it. Oh, it might be a little bit close though. And we're gonna want the same size of trailers. And this would actually open up a possibility of having two trailers and trucks for the next harvest, which would be an interesting thing to see. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it looks like I somehow bought a different brand of tractor. Or truck, even though they look exactly the same. Yeah, that's a 6x6 agro truck, not a man. Huh, they look practically the same. Oh, the other one has the double things at the back. That's what's different. Okay. Copy course of no... Yep, copy course of that. And we'll... it was supposed to copy that course. Push that. Okay, now it's got it loaded. Okay, good. So we should see it when we go here, if I actually have it turned on to see everything. So now, if we don't get blindsided by that other truck, this guy, yep, he's gonna go. And this guy's barely getting to the bunker, so that's why we need this. Except he doesn't stop. That's the other problem, is he doesn't slow down. And, yeah, I don't know. I might have to see, like, maybe you're supposed to put a waypoint in the middle of the bunker or something. But, anyway, I'm going to let this run. If it doesn't end up working, I'm just going to not save the game like I usually do if something doesn't work. Because why waste money on a second truck and trailer if I don't need it? Actually, that makes me wonder, why did I buy that other one? Oh, because it's cheaper and for some reason has slightly more horsepower. Anyway, let's see if this guy can do it automatically. He's not even in the right mode, that would help. I think he was in, like, fieldwork mode. Oh, and I forgot automatic search is crap. And it might just be because I have a bunch of modded stuff, and that probably confuses it. There we go. So he's going to go. We should see the other one pretty close by the time this one gets done. Okay, because what I'm worried about is turning, like, especially on top of small fields like this. Because, I mean, like, this is why I like to use overloaders, if at all possible. But I don't think anyone's made an overloader that does silage, or I would just do like I usually do. And the other problem is that, for some reason in this mode, like, especially in bunkers, instead of stopping and overloading, the trucks just keep driving at whatever speed you were driving, but if you don't drive that fast, then the trucks will get stuck once the bunker fills up, and you'd probably have trucks that are not even half empty driving all the way back for stupid reasons. Let's see, so the other truck is just about back, so let's see if it automatically can detect that it doesn't need to go out yet, because in all my looking, I have not seen a setting that has, like, number of trucks doing the same job or anything. Okay, but it looks like... Okay, so it looks like it's waiting Maybe the one wait thing is waiting for the other trailer, because, yeah, that's the one thing I haven't quite ever understood, is if two vehicles are driving the same course, do they share any information? And maybe they do, because maybe this guy, like, maybe ideally you'd have it set so that at 50% of the other trailer he comes, and at 90% of his trailer he leaves. And obviously, in that case, you'd want the numbers to both be the same, so he leaves right when the other truck is coming. But, yeah, let's see if he's going to hit this wall. Oh, we won't be able to tell for at least one more, but if we look like this, we should be able to tell. And one thing I've noticed is some walls, like telephone poles, like if we watch, yeah, he's going to go around the telephone pole. But if it's an actual wall, like that wall around the granary over there. So if I stop this guy, is that other truck just automatically going to start going? Because that could be a problem if it does. Okay, no it doesn't, which is interesting because I thought it would. And yeah, sorry if... I hope you guys don't mind just doing a bunch of course play stuff, but I'd like to ideally get every step of every process automated because, yeah. Anyway, let's see. So, 17%. I think I'm going to go look up if you're supposed to put a waypoint in the silo, because if I can, I would like to not have to chop this field 6 times in a row. Plus, my throat's getting really dry. I'll be right back. Hey guys, I'm back. So I'm kind of stuck right now because course play is a butthead. Oh my gosh, how did you even manage that course play? Get that trailer out of there. Well, I might be resetting that trailer. But anyway, so after more testing and watching a few videos, I found out that if the trailer gets full and you don't just hit the drive now button, the worker will actually slow down when they go through the bunker, but sometimes it messes it up if you interfere with them. And obviously this worker got stuck, and I'm trying to get him aligned properly. Gonna let that give a new waypoint, so he should, of course not. Yeesh, I really need to find, like, someone needs to make a mod that can just delete entities, like that stupid yellow box and other stuff like it. But anyway guys, I'll be right back after this harvest. Just because it's going to be really repetitive, so I'll be right back.